yes, higher income people and businesses leave if you have graduated income tax or progressive income tax. Let me make the case that the lowest income people in the state benefit from a flat rate income tax. Again, I'm originally from Massachusetts before I emigrated to the United States. But in Massachusetts, we have by constitution a flat rate, single rate tax. And what that means, and five times the advocates of bigger spending have put on the ballot in Massachusetts a move to a graduated grad tax, graduated progressive income tax. And they actually have in legislation which would prove that year one, if you pass the constitutional change, we will have a law change so that Teddy Kennedy pays more, but almost everybody else pays less. And five times the people of Massachusetts had a very sophisticated conversation. Yeah, if you divide us into 12 different groups and you mug the highest income group first, then when you come back for me, Ted Kennedy will go, you're on your own, kid. He already raised my taxes. And if you divide people into different groups, you can mug them one at a time. This is the Richard Speck theory of tax increases. Now, if you can't deal with everybody in the room at once, you take them out of the room one at a time. And moving to a graduated income tax allows dividing the electorate into different groups that then get hit at different times. And so over time, the lowest income person in Massachusetts is protected by the fact that their interests are linked with Ted Kennedy's, and that you can't raise their taxes without raising Ted Kennedy's too. And that gives them much greater protection. Because the politician says, I've got a great idea. And what Obama and Bill Clinton, Obama just Xeroxed Bill Clinton's argument, I'm willing to tax the top 2%, okay? Just the rest of you, this won't affect you, just these guys. So you might want to step out of the room. It's not going to be pleasant, but it's not you. If you can do that to groups, then of course they came back for people who were married and for people who drive cars and for people who use gasoline and for people with pensions, because they divided people up and it came after them one by one. If you have to take on everybody in the room at once, they've got a really good idea and you're all paying for it. Okay, we're all listening. What's this really good idea that we should all pay for? And if it's a really good idea, you got a deal. It's when they know they don't have a really good idea that they tell 95 or 98% of the population, you wouldn't like this if you were paying for it, but I'm gonna make somebody else pay for it. And so flat rate tax, I would argue, for political reasons, for over time, not just this year, the best protection for all taxpayers is knowing that the guy to your left, the guy to your right, the guy on the big hill, all are paying the same rate you are. That's what keeps your rate from increasing.